Vanakkam, namaste, and blessings to everyone. This is Dr. Bhairavi Balasubramanian, PhD, the Sky Priestess. Right now, Mercury and Uranus are conjunct in Taurus. This is a powerful energy of breakthrough or breakdown. So be careful with this energy. The reason I say this is because Mercury deals with our thoughts, our ideas, our communication, our mind, the way we perceive things and express ourselves in our immediate environments. It has a lot to do with a lot more other things, but I'm trying to make this a short video because it's late at night and I want to get to bed. So Mercury's energy really deals with our ability to think, our ability to see the world the way we do, and our ability to take our ideas and use it as a bridge to other people. So this is what it deals with. Uranus deals with our connection with higher mind, what we are channeling from source, and the ideas that are floating about in the collective. And when the two come together, you get a very, very, very powerful activation, especially to the upper chakras. So this is a time where you can really make leaps and conceptual, you know, bounds in the way you see things, and to actually make breakthroughs to kind of shake loose old ideas and entrenched structures of cognition that have kind of eluded you for a long time. So that's wonderful. But at the same time, this breakthrough energy can also lead to breakdown if a person is ungrounded or unwilling to confront truths that have sustained them in a way that does not truly align with their spirit. So whilst some of you will be using this energy to really launch your message forwards, others may need to take a breather and just sit, cuddle themselves, and really feel into what is coming up for them. You should not be pushing yourself with this alignment if you feel ungrounded or unstable. In fact, those who feel that way may want to seek out a counselor or facilitator or a safe space where they can simply just be without feeling that pressure to perform, to do, breakthrough, 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 go now. No. If you feel you can't handle it, don't push yourself. Like for reals. Because this energy can literally land a lot of people, you know, spending the night under observation in a hospital somewhere. I ain't kidding. And the reason why this is so incredibly strong is because Mercury and Uranus come together in the sign of Taurus. That deals with the question of embodiment. It deals with the way, with our very physicality in this world. It deals with questions of value and worth and abundance. And you don't need to just measure that in terms of money. It can also be our emotional value, the depth of reserves, of emotional reserves and self-worth that we have within ourselves. And this can be a time that's very, very challenging for those whose sense of self-worth and value has been compromised. Whether it's through neglect, abuse, really bad relationships, call it what you want. This is a time for greater self-care. And again, some of you can break through that past trauma and conditioning, and some of you will really be feeling vulnerable from it, sometimes both. So it's not like one size fits all interpretation. Astrology never is. So with Mercury and Uranus conjunct in Taurus on the plus side, it's a great time for us to collectively be breaking through very false or outmoded ideas of value and abundance. You know, truly, this planet is abundant. We have resources to support and sustain all of us, but we lack the political will to use them efficiently. We also need to understand that there is a profound energetic give and take that needs to be happening between humanity and this planet so that every being can live on this planet in peace. And this is an awareness that's also coming to all of us now. We are also moving more so, especially with the influence of technology, back into that system where communities actually support each other. Now, whilst we don't live in old times where, you know, there's a barter system and you can just kind of go to your next door neighbor and get what you need, we live in a much more complex economic world. We are increasingly seeing technology as a means where groups of people can fund people all across the planet to go and do different things and good things in the world. And this is a good thing. This is a great thing. At the same time, we can see these same technological channels used to try and break down the self-worth of others or to break down the feeling of, what's the word, of someone just having the right to be here. And we see that rising a lot with the kind of vitriol that's spewed on social media and hate crimes that are targeted against people who simply don't fit the status quo. So, you know, really, this energy can go in many, many different ways. So use it for good. Use this energy to put, if you can, use this energy to put a good message out there, to support causes that you actually believe in, to well, put your money where your mouth is. And to actually, in your own way, support and sustain and contribute to the upkeep and welfare of this planet and the people who are helping that process. So in some sense, this is an invitation for all of us to come together, chip in, and get the job done. Now, there's a lot of stigma surrounding money, especially because of what the 1% have pretty much done to the rest of the planet. But for the most part, most people who are talking to you are not going to be in that 1% tier. So telling them that, you know, they don't deserve to be happy or they don't deserve to have good things because somebody else doesn't have good things is a bit much. Those kinds of arguments tend to come from the other person's lack of self-worth and valuation. Unless you're actually talking about taking down that 1%, you know, these kind of arguments actually just try to destabilize another self-worth and really don't add anything good to the collective. I say this as especially for fellow facilitators and spiritualists because this is the kind of bullshit that gets thrown our way. I know a lot of my friends, I know a lot of good people who do really good work out there, and they feel shy or ashamed or embarrassed to step up and claim what they are worth because of some creme de la creme of society, so to speak, screwing over the rest of humanity. It doesn't work that way. Just know that people use these words as weapons and that one may be a bit more vulnerable to these words, especially at a time where Mercury is conjunct Uranus. So remember, generally speaking, this is a time that you can really build someone up or break them down. So use this energy wisely and again, use it for good. Now, in terms of myself, and I'm quite excited by what I've accomplished today because I'm someone who practices what I preach. I have started finally using my Instagram account. You can find it there at The Sky Priestess. I did my first live video. It was very exciting. I spent a couple of hours doing some catching up with and doing some spiritual work with a good friend of mine. Very Uranian energy of support and creating general abundance and respect for one another. Very beautiful work. I had a really difficult conversation with a family member about stuff that's been going on for like decades, and I don't know how I managed it, but I came at a place of centeredness and I did not allow anything to shift me out of it. I mean, I'm giving myself a thumbs up for that. I've also created a new format and template where all clients who book a session with me through my software get an email detailing what to expect from a session, you know, kind of pre-preparation work, post-session work, and so on and so forth. So, you know, I've been really getting organized. And last but not least, I have found a solution to something that a lot of you have been asking me to do, and that is to set up a way that you can contribute. So on my website, www.bhairavibalasubramaniam.com, you're going to find a link that says contribute. And that's where you get to decide what you want to give me for the work that I put out in the world. I don't care if it's $1,000. I don't care if it's $1. If you want to give something back to me, you do what your heart feels. And that's fine. You know the worth of the work. You know the value of it and what it does for your life. You know the time and energy that it takes for me to do all of this stuff. Because this isn't just me talking to you on video. This is like a day, you know, every single day, watching the energy, working with the energy, working on myself, doing the articles, doing the sessions, so on and so forth. It's a life. It's not something that you can measure in 15 minutes or 10 minutes or whatever. So if you want to support my material and physical existence, you can become a monthly contributor. And again, it is purely voluntary because I do not believe in denying people truths that can really help them just because they may not be able to afford it. And that is my dharma. Now, I do have a special tier for people who do want to pay a little extra. They will get an exclusive monthly overview. This is more like a token of thanks, a bonus, so to speak. And that is for people who contribute above a certain amount. In any case, you will still get the same information, just in a more ad hoc, as and when it occurs, as and when spirit guides me to do so process. So this is the best that I could do for this question. And a lot of you have been asking me to do this for a long time. So I've finally gone ahead and done it. And I hope that you are ready to do the needful. Do what your heart tells you to do. So that's what I got to say for today. I've been really working with this energy in a productive way. And I hope that the rest of you will also do so. And I've also had to support someone who was really feeling very ungrounded with this energy, which is part of the reason why I'm staying up instead of going to bed. and doing this video, because it can really work both ways. Please take care of yourselves, take care of others when you can, and know your worth and know the worth of others too. That's about it. Take care. Many blessings, lots of love. Ciao, ciao for now. Good night.